The multi-million dollar orders are in for four huge boring machines set to dig their way under the city as part of the Melbourne Metro Tunnel. Seven News has been given the first glimpse at what they'll look like in action as the Public Transport Minister confirmed the project is a year ahead of schedule.
The Metro Tunnel's boring machines are huge. Each one is 100 metres long. Although their work is slow going, every 24 hours they'll cut through just 10 metres of stone and dirt. And the Public Transport Minister, Jacinta Allen, is very protective of them.
They're not boring. There's nothing boring about these machines.
They'll be ready to go first thing next year. Two will start digging the 9-kilometre section of tunnel at North Melbourne's Arden Station, the other two at the Domain Station site near the Shrine.
It'll essentially be a factory under the ground as it works around the clock to construct the Metro Tunnel.
It's important work which those behind the project say will significantly ease the current public transport pain.
What it'll do is actually unlock the city loop, which is currently full, and this project creates a bypass of the existing city loop.
The $11 billion project consists of five new stations, and the state government has confirmed it's now 1 year ahead of schedule. When complete, a trip across the city from here at the eventual Anzac station to Parkville in the north will take just 9 minutes.
It will give us the turn-up-and-go style of services that you see in other international cities around the world.
All going well, the new Metro Rail network will be up and running by 2025. Michael Scanlon, 7 News.